Well, episode 5 already. In this episode of Best Case Scenario, we will be looking at the Prisma case, a case that was actually released pretty recently, on March 13th, 2019 to be exact. It was announced in this Seeing the Light update. It features 17 community designed weapon finishes and is highlighted by the Horizon knives and Chroma finishes. You know, the four knives we discussed in the previous two episodes of the series. The Navaja knife, the Stiletto knife, the Ursus and the Talon knives. For the Horizon and Danger Zone cases, these knives came with the original finishes, those being most famously the Fade, Crimson Web and Case Hardened finishes. Just to name a few. For the Chroma finishes, we now got the Marble Fade, the Tiger Tooth, Rust Coat and Doppler finishes, among others. Among the Doppler finishes, you have your Rubies, Sapphires and Black Pearls, which can go for absurd amounts of money. How much does a Talon Knife Ruby in Factory New cost, for example? Oh, how about $4,700, according to CS Money. And the Sapphire trades for only a cheeky $6,500. So suffice to say, this case features some of the best finishes you can get, just in terms of their prices. But let's not fool ourselves and think that getting any of these expensive finishes is likely and will make the case explode in price anytime soon. Otherwise, the Chroma cases would already be going for multiple euros. But they're not, so let's all collectively calm down. And also, let's take a step back in general and let's see where the Prisma case finds itself in the drop pool system. Currently, it's in the prime drop pool, right in the middle. The Prisma 2 case has also already been released, by the way, but that's the case we will look at in the next episode. But just the fact that there's another Prisma case tells us that the first Prisma case could move to the non-prime pool within the year and even move to the rare pool whenever Valve feel like it. Because usually, Valve like to keep at least one case with a specific set of knives as an active prime or non-prime drop, so having released the second Prisma case, the original will definitely find its way to the rare pool in the coming years. When that will happen is going to be decided by Valve entirely, but the case should be a non-prime drop within 12 months, and then a rare drop in about 24 more months after that, at least if Valve keep their current system in place and don't start moving cases like the Revolver and Chroma 3 cases to the rare pool as well. So overall, my prediction would be that the case becomes a rare drop around the start of 2024. This is obviously not only dependent on whether Valve keep their rotation system in place, but also on how many cases they release in the future. More cases means the Prisma case moves pools faster and vice versa. As for the case's current popularity, we can look at three numbers. The first, Steam market listings. The Prisma case is the only remaining case that still has over 1 million listings on the community market, which used to be a normal quantity for just about any active case. Now, the only case that comes close to its quantity is the Danger Zone case, which has about 500,000 fewer listings. Of course, this also makes the Prisma case the cheapest case to purchase right now. If you're okay with waiting for a couple weeks, you will easily be able to get it at 3 cents on a buy order. I myself have gotten it a few times for 1 cent even on Buff, where thousands of these sell for 2 cents right now, so yeah. It's far and away the cheapest case out there current. But does the high quantity mean that people don't like the case? For that, let's look at the other two numbers available to us. These two, thanks to the work done by the Reddit user Fiedik. In its lifetime up until March 11th, it had been unboxed over 40 million times approximately, which makes it among the most popular cases that have been released in the past 3 years. In the past month, again according to Fiedik's findings, the Prisma case has been unboxed another 2 million times. So it and the Prisma 2 case are the two least unboxed prime drops right now. Though it still beats active cases like the Revolver and Chroma 3 case, who go for a similar price. The difference is that these are non-prime drops, which usually drop less often than Prisma cases, and also they are seen as cases you could invest in right now, since they are so old and could become rare drops next. Though that would mean Valve have to deviate from their current rotation system. So yeah, from this we can see that the Prisma case does have some unboxing interest behind it, even if it is considerably lower than for the Fracture and Clutch cases. As for why it has so much more quantity on the market in comparison to the Prisma 2 case? That's a good question. From what I have gathered, the Prisma 2 case seems to have more popular skins. For example, it doesn't have a second covert that absolutely stinks when it comes to its value. So I would have expected it to have been unboxed more often. But obviously, this graph tells us a different story. A different explanation for this could be that the Prisma 2 case is only a year old and thus didn't have as much time to accumulate quantity, especially during this time where the demand in cases is at an all-time high. For example, the Prisma 1 case, during a time where the sales volume remained pretty consistent from August 2020 to January 2021, increased in Steam listings from 400,000 to 1.7 million. Meanwhile, the Prisma 2 case, which was released last March, managed to increase its listings to 750,000 until that time, and since then, the interest in both cases has been pretty similar. Meaning, since January 2021, the Prisma case had 1 million more quantity on the market to work with than the Prisma 2 case, which obviously explains the discrepancy in Steam listings between the two cases. Okay, I've touched on the skins for a bit there, so before we go any further, I think it's time we look at what the Prisma case has to offer apart from its knives, which we have already talked about. To sum the knives up again, Dopplers that can make you rich, rust coats that can make you... Okay, now the skins. Again, we looked at the coverts for a little bit. The M4A4 Emperor is a very popular skin that also goes for a decent price. The 5-7 Angry Mob on the other hand, oof. That's definitely not gonna boost sales for this case. Other than that, the AUG and XM skins are decent pulls at good floats, and the AUG Aetheris is an above average restricted skin. Apart from the Deagle Light Rail among the others, nothing else has decent value, but in total, we are left with a few skins that you won't be disappointed by if you unbox them. As for the ROI for this case, we're looking at a pretty average return of 53% in the long run. There are better cases out there, but you can see just by looking at the Operation Breakout and Clutch cases that ROI is not the main factor for why cases are unboxed. Still would have liked to see a bit of a higher ROI for the Prisma case since it's so cheap and since it can't really flex with butterfly knives or gloves like the aforementioned two cases. And the Prisma case does include one of, if not the cheapest knife in the game, the Navaja knife rust coat. So even if you could get a Talon Doppler, there's a chance you could get a 65 euro knife as well, which won't help the case's prospects either. One other thing that is worth a mention is that in this video, TDM Jesus mentions that the chance to get a Ruby or Sapphire knife is about 4 times higher in Prisma and Spectrum cases than in the Chroma cases, which will undoubtedly help to keep the Prisma case relevant for unboxings in the foreseeable future. And with that, let's get into the question of whether or not you should invest into this case and whether you should do it right now. Now, first of all, it's important to note that the Prisma case won't become a rare drop anytime soon and won't go up in price significantly either, unless it becomes a non-prime drop when the next case comes out. But even then, we can anticipate that the increase in price would be limited and slow just by looking at its quantity. In any other scenario though, the Prisma case will keep going for 3 cents on buy orders for a long time. So if you do want to invest, make sure to definitely get them for 3 cents. At that point, you invest at maximum efficiency in terms of your buy-in price, and you make the most low-risk investment there is in CSGO. But as for the question whether you should invest at all, that depends on if you can answer both of these questions with a yes. Number one, are you okay with waiting for at least 3 years to see somewhat of a decent return for the Prisma case? And number two, do you have enough funds to be able to lock some of them up in an investment that will give you zero returns for 3 years? What I mean by that is that instead of putting 3 cents into each Prisma case, you could put them into RMR, Broken Fang, Discontinued Collections, other cases and future collections, which will almost all give you a solid ROI in the coming years. While in comparison, during that time, the Prisma case is likely to give you no returns at all. If you invest 100 euros into Broken Fang items, for example, you could cash out, let's say, 200 euros in a few months and reinvest those into something else. While with the Prisma case, your 100 euros are likely to remain 100 euros until about 2024. That's why it's important that you invest your main funds into investments that could net you returns more quickly, and only invest a few percent of your total budget into something like the Prisma case. The pro argument for investing here is simple. The Prisma case will never become cheaper than 3 cents, and you will be able to buy it in very high quantities, which, once the price does start going up, will multiply your profits by a lot. I myself have 1,409 Prisma cases in my inventory right now, and only put 2% of my current budget into it. That percentage will get smaller and smaller the more money I put into CSGO, but my point is, it's just a little side investment that I made, since I'm comfortable with waiting it out for many years while also focusing on more short-term investments. So yeah, this is a question you have to answer for yourself. If you're looking for your first case investment and want to see faster returns, I would first of all wait out the release of the new case and then invest into one of the non-prime or rare cases, since those have a better chance of increasing in price more quickly. Just make sure to not invest right now, since most prices still are pretty inflated due to the very high current demand in cases. With more and more people getting vaccinated, the operation coming to an end, and summertime right around the corner, it is more likely than not that player numbers will start to decrease a bit and case demand to become lower. Obviously, a thriving market is a plus for all of us, and I'm not saying I want any kind of demand to decrease. I'm just saying what is likely to happen and what you should definitely keep in mind, especially when you consider investing into cases at the current price points. Also, if you do currently own Prisma cases, whether you got them as drops or already invested into them, do not sell them. With Steam tags taking most of the cuts, all you do is throw money out of the window, even if it's just 2 cents per sale. Just leave them in your inventory or stash them in a storage unit and forget about them for a few years. As for the potential of these cases, I've talked about it a bit in this video, but mostly the demand will depend on how many people are interested in the more popular finishes for these knives in the future, mainly the Sapphire and Ruby finishes, since they are the most expensive. If the Talon knife further increases in popularity as well, that will obviously improve the potential of this case. I wouldn't expect this case to become ridiculously expensive anytime soon, but a year or two after it becomes a rare drop, somewhere between 30 and 40 cents is where I will see this case. And with that, we have come to the end of this episode. Thank you for watching as always, have a good one.